Hello aquaponics growers, this is Jonathan from Melbourne Aquaponics. So my aim is to help you to grow sustainable, healthy and tasty food locally in your own backyard thanks to aquaponics. Today I would like to talk about the main difference between aquaculture and aquaponics. So aquaponics is a combination of two techniques that are aquaculture and hydroponics. That's on the paper, right? But in practice, it's completely different. What we do in aquaponics, we work with a whole ecosystem. In aquaculture, we are growing fish, and the only aim is to produce fish. There is nothing else that is important, and we are not dealing with an ecosystem. We are just dealing with the fish we are trying to grow. So the aim are completely different. You understand, in aquaponics, the aim is to maintain a good ecosystem. So the fish, but also the bacteria and the vegetables and all the insects, the worms that are living all together. So in aquaponics, we really try to give the best chances to this ecosystem to grow and to produce a nice quality food. So we are talking about vegetables. You know, in aquaponics, we grow 10 times veggies than fish. In aquaculture, it's completely different, right? The aim is to really produce as many fish as possible. So the density that we're going to have in aquaculture is going to be way higher than what we're going to have in aquaponics. One big difference is the density of fish. So obviously, to maintain this density of fish in aquaculture, we are using some very specific equipment that costs a lot of money. So in aquaculture, they use pure oxygen that they're going to dilute with the water later on, and to sursaturate, oversaturate the concentration of oxygen into the water. In aquaponics, that's different. The oxygen that we're going to have in our setup is just going to be bring thanks to an aeration. So we're just going to agitate, we're just going to mix basically the atmosphere with the water to saturate the water in oxygen and to balance the concentration. So, you know, the technique we use are definitely different. And this brings us to the whole mindset that we're going to have in aquaponics. This is where we have a huge difference. The mindset we have in aquaponics is that we want to maintain our system in the best conditions. We want all the living creatures to live in good conditions, to avoid stress, and therefore to avoid disease. Simply because in our setup, we want to produce food that is very healthy, that is 100% healthy and sustainable. But also, if there is a problem, we physically can't really treat the problem. You know, if your fish are falling sick, you don't want to add any chemical in the setup, otherwise it will have an impact on the bacteria that are living in the grow bed. While in aquaculture, when there is a disease, the fish farmers are putting some chemicals into the ponds, into the rivers, into the cages wherever the fish are grown, and they just release this in the environment. So it's gonna basically kill the parasites or the bacteria that are living on the fish. If the fish are sick due to bacteria infection, they can also use antibiotics. So sometimes they put antibiotics into the fish food, and therefore they treat the fish. In aquaponics, if we do this, obviously the antibiotics are going to be into the water, and they're going to be raised into the grow bed where the bacteria are living. And therefore we're going to lose our population of bacteria. So we definitely don't want to use this technique to manage the quantity of disease that we have in aquaponics. So the principle is very simple. In aquaculture, the fish are grown in very, very high density, therefore they are stressed, they are grown in poor conditions, and the fish farmer have to basically use some chemicals, antibiotics, sometimes vaccines to manage the disease. While in aquaponics, the way we manage the disease is that we give the best condition to the fish, so they live in nice condition and they don't fall sick at the first place. So it means not overstock your ponds, so working with low density of fish and giving the best conditions to your fish. So that's the really big difference we have between aquaponics and aquaculture. So before we stop this video, I have one question for you. guess what this is? I found this and I thought I really have to share this with you. It has nothing to do with aquaponics really, but I think that's a very interesting object. It has to do with permaculture, and the shape is very unusual here. So you can give me your response in the comment of this video, and the one who gets the correct response, the first one to give me the correct response, I will offer him the digital aquaponics manual. So yeah, give me your response in the comments and I will give you the response to this question next week in the next video. If you are new to aquaponics, I give you a free training at the end of this video. You go into the description and you're going to find a link that is going to give you access to this free training, which is a six-step process to help you to build your own aquaponics setup, but also to understand the principles of aquaponics and to understand the critical limits that you really need to respect in order to build an efficient aquaponics setup, but also to manage it in the best condition. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and share it with your friends.
Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop!